Greetings. I wanted to briefly address the current world events we see in the Middle East. Let's take a look at the map. So, here we have the Middle East. Israel is the little green spot in the middle. And rioting has been going on in many Arab countries. Iran had corrupt elections last year and crushed the protesters. Mohamed Bouazizi lit himself on fire in Tunisia, starting riots in Tunisia that toppled the government. Then we watched riots in Egypt topple Mubarak, and the Muslim Brotherhood were actively involved. The Muslim Brotherhood was previously outlawed in Egypt because they helped assassinate Anwar Sadat. Now we are watching Libya in the last days before its dictator is overthrown. There have been protests in Jordan, and the king changed the government, promising change. Lebanon, of course, is a puppet state of Islamic Iran. Hamas uses it to launch attacks against Israel. Even little Bahrain has been having widely reported protests instigated by Hezbollah, another terrorist group. Yemen is a proven terrorist training ground. Even Iraq is getting in on protests. During the Day of Rage, 20 protesters were killed by security forces. Syria has not seen much protesting yet. Bashar al-Assad is a very harsh dictator and is controlling the situation internally. Saudi Arabia has tried to stop protests, offering $10.7 billion in benefits to citizens. Turkey has not had any such protests yet, but they actively were participating in the Gaza flotillas to attack Israel. Even little old Kuwait has had protests of non-citizen Arabs. These incidents are currently considered minor. Darfur, Sudan, is a racist civil war with Arabs, meaning Muslims, killing African Christians. Muslim pirates in Somalia wage war and extortion against all sea traffic off their coasts, killing civilians and travelers. Protests are happening in Algeria, but are being effectively suppressed by the police at this time. It's remarkable how quickly these nations have suddenly become unstable and are at risk of changing. But what exactly are they changing into? What is the likely outcome of these events? Let's take a moment and look at the Word of God. In the book of Daniel, chapter 2, there is a vision by King Nebuchadnezzar. It describes four kingdoms or empires. The fourth kingdom is described this way, Daniel chapter 2, verse 40. And the fourth kingdom shall be strong as iron, for as much as iron breaks in pieces and subdues all things, and as iron that breaks all these, shall it break in pieces and bruise. And whereas thou saw the feet and toes, part of potter's clay and part of iron, the kingdom shall be divided, but there shall be in it of the strength of the iron, forasmuch as thou saw the iron mixed with miry clay. Remember this phrase, mixed with miry clay. Daniel 2:42. And as the toes of the feet were part of iron and part of clay, so the kingdom shall be partly strong and partly broken. And whereas thou saw iron mixed with miry clay, look back a little more at Daniel 2. Daniel 2 verse 31. Thou, O king, sawest and beheld a great image. This great image, whose brightness was excellent, stood before thee, and the form thereof was terrible. This image's head was of fine gold, his breast and his arms of silver, his belly and his thighs of brass, his legs of iron, his feet part of iron and part of clay. Thou sawest till that a stone was cut out without hands, which smote the image upon his feet that were of iron and clay, and broke them into pieces. A stone. The stone will crush the feet. The mixed empire. So think about this. The stone will crush the fourth empire. A stone? The stone. Daniel 2 verse 35. Then was the iron, the clay, the brass, the silver, and the gold broken to pieces together, and became like the chaff of the summer threshing floors, and the wind carried them away that no place was found for them. And the stone that smote the image became a great mountain, and filled the whole earth. This is the dream, and we will tell the interpretation thereof before the king. So Prophet Daniel told the king what the dream was. And as the toes of the feet were part of iron and part of clay, so the kingdom shall be partly strong and partly broken. And whereas thou saw iron mixed with miry clay, they shall mingle themselves with the seed of men. But they shall not cleave one to another, even as iron is not mixed with clay. And in the days of these kings shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed. And the kingdom shall not be left to another people, but it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. Let's look a little closer at the original Hebrew. Daniel chapter 2, verse 43. And whereas thou sawest iron mixed with miry clay. And here again in the same verse it says, one to another, even as iron is not mixed with clay. Well, let's look a little more at the direct transliteration. Here we see the usage of the word mixed. Here's the Hebrew lettering. And we see there a number that has been assigned to this Aramaic word. It's number 6151. We can look it up in Strong's Concordance. 6151, Arab. The transliteration? Arab. It means to mix or combine. The fourth kingdom is Arab. The stone will crush the feet. The mixed empire. The Arab empire. I believe the current popular Christian eschatology that focuses on the revived Roman Empire is simply wrong. I believe that today we are seeing the revival of the Turkish Ottoman Empire, the Fourth Empire. Watch the news for continued protests, more involvement by the Muslim Brotherhood and by Islamic terrorist organizations. And watch especially for a new caliphate. Watch for the United Arab States, a unified coalition of no fewer than 10 Arab nations. I don't think it has to exactly be 10 because of the 10 toes. Know this, the man who steps forward and leads this caliphate will be the man defeated by the Son of God, will be the Antichrist foretold by the Word of God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.